evening, everyone.
Welcome.
Good evening.
I had this problem with my microphone once before, and I said, "Sorry, I'm having a problem with my microphone," and they said, "And also with you." So we struggle along. Everything happens at the last minute. It's pretty hard to get prepared for everything. Murphy's Law takes over. Today, there's a special statement that I'd like to read to you from Cardinal Collins. He's the Archbishop of Toronto, and he has a statement about the death of Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI. Through the Archdiocese of Toronto, we join in mourning the loss of Pope Benedict XVI. We give thanks for his years of faithful and thoughtful, inspiring service to the Church as a priest for more than 70 years, and in his time as a bishop, the Supreme Pontiff, and as Pope, offered each of us a personal example of fidelity and of what it is to be a devoted disciple of Jesus. As a theologian, he followed in the footsteps of great Saint Augustine in offering to us his profound insights into the mystery of our Christian faith, insight arising from God's grace, not only in his astonishing intellect and learning, but also in his personal holiness and pastoral care for God's people. His writings will help guide disciples of Jesus in the centuries that lie ahead. As Pope, he led the universal church with wisdom and holiness, providing a clear and loving message of how our faith can inspire us and guide us through the storms of life's journeys. More than ever, his own witness, humility, and invitation to put others before himself should resonate throughout the world. We pray for the repose of his soul. May eternal rest grant upon him, O Lord, and let the perpetual light shine upon him. Amen. And we begin our prayers this day in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we ask for the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit to be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today's Mass is being offered for Ken Holichuk for his healing. And we begin our prayers this day. I'm really mixed up today. As we approach the altar of the Lord, we take a moment to call to mind how much in need we are of the gift of God's mercy in our lives.
You sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Seeds of the Father, of the Father, have mercy.
O God, who through the fruitful virginity of the Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the offer of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord spoke to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, Thus you shall bless the children of Israel. You shall say to them, The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. So they shall put my name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption to sonship. And because you are sons and daughters, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, "Abba, Father." So you are no longer slave, but son. And if son, then also heir through God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The shepherds went with haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what they had been told about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child, and he was named Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was consumed in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There has been an awful lot written about Mary, such a great deal, and it's hard to kind of encapsulate her in one kind of homily. But there's a couple of things in here that I think are important for us. Who was Mary, and how can we know about Mary? Well, I think we can know about Mary through our own intellect and what God thinks about the creation of Our Lady. It was just this reason. If we just unpack it through a rational perspective, that's what Fulton Sheen did through his wonderful book, The World's First Love. If we were to consider ourselves God today, I know that's kind of difficult, but if we were, and we thought about it, you see, you as God were making your own mother. Now, we don't make our own mothers, right, because we're not born before Mary. But of course, Jesus was before Mary. And he was making his own mother. If I was making my own mother, I would make her flawless, wouldn't I? I'd make her immaculate and perfect. A ravishing, beautiful mom on every level that there could be. It is what I would do. It's likely what God would do. We call her the Immaculate Conception, free of original sin. I would make my mum's delicate little feet strong enough to crush Satan's ugly face, as we see at the bottom of many of the statues of Mary. And I would not stop there. Oh no, I'm going to not deprive my mother of any blessing that a mother could have. I would make my mother not only an immaculate creation, but you know what else I would do? I would give my mother the gift of virginity. Perpetual virginity. As a matter of fact, I would astound the nations and the world with this gift and make it so that my mother was a virgin before, during, and after my birth. God can do this because nothing is impossible for God. You know that light passes through a window, and if, of course, we were seeing it, we would see it, but it's a little dark right now. But life passes through a window, and it doesn't break the integrity of the glass, no, but it really passes through the window, leaving it intact, doesn't it? Well, who is Jesus? Jesus is light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made. He's God. He could do this. He can pass through things and leave the integrity of that thing intact. That's what he did with his mother's womb. God did not deprive his mother of any blessing, immaculate, perpetual virginity. This is the teaching of the church. God would want everyone to love his mother, wouldn't he? Remember Jesus on the cross. Behold your mother. Jesus so loved Mary that he would make it so that my mother would never die. Well, my mother does die, but he didn't want his mother to die. And we'll talk about this near the end of the homily. This is just the first person of the incarnate Word talking. Now, I want you to act like you're the Father. Because remember, God's Trinitarian, Father, Son, Spirit. And she is a Trinitarian masterpiece. Now, your God, the Father, you would be creating the mystery of Mary in a perfect little girl. Your perfect little daughter, your princess. God made the most beautiful little girl, and he's going to protect her and make her the queen of the universe and the queen of heaven. She is like the Ark of the Covenant. The Father is madly in love with this little girl because he made her. Now the Holy Spirit, another part of that Trinity, is also involved. And the Holy Spirit's going to have a say in making this masterpiece of femininity. What's the Holy Spirit going to make? I love this one. The perfect bride. The perfect bride. God made a masterpiece, and he made it in a loving masterpiece. You know what he did? He took up residency in the body of this masterpiece. Yep. That's how much he loved her. Madly in love with her. Now, how much does he love her? He makes her smell like roses. She is a masterpiece of the Holy Trinity. St. Augustine talks about Mary being the mold of Christians. If we were to line up all of the saints, whether it's Francis, Dominic, Benedict, all the different saints, you would find the first thing, if you ask them, why did you found your religious order? The first thing they would say is, of course, for Jesus. But then if you said, brothers, was there anything else you wanted them to do? And they would say, yes, but God's first always. But Mary's not God. What else have you got for us, brothers? I give it to you. Every single one of them would say that those who follow the charism and the apostolic spirituality, they would seek to become like Our Lady. Another Mary for Jesus. That is at the core of Christianity. You retain your own identity. You are your own person. But you have to become like Our Lady. That's what it's all about. Allow Jesus to so enter your life and your soul that you become like Mary. Someone who gives birth to Christ in their life and in their families, in their community, and all around them. As we call for Mary's assistance in our lives by praying the Hail Mary, we, like all the saints, place ourselves under the mantle of Mary, our mother. Because of that sweet woman, I know now Jesus Christ. I chose of my own free will to make vows of poverty, chastity, and obedience. I would have never done this if I had not known this beautiful woman. Every person has to fight for beauty. I'm not here primarily to fight for an institution. I don't fight for Walmart, right? But we fight for beauty. We seek beauty in our lives. Beauty is so important. We as Catholics are supposed to be seeking that beauty. And Our Lady will bring that dimension into our lives. You know, we can't have anything without Our Lady. Jesus chose to come to us through a woman. He could have done this so many different ways. A million different ways he could have. But no, he chose to be born of her. That means that we're all dependent on her by causation, if you want to call it that. We need her. She is not an option. She's an absolute necessity in our lives. We have this obligation in a spiritual life to seek her help, to ask her to help us be like her. You can't have Jesus without her. That means we can't have life without her. What did Jesus say? Unless you eat this flesh and drink this blood, you don't have life in you. And where is that? Well, where did that flesh and blood come from? The flesh and blood of Mary. Without Mary, we would not have Jesus. Without Mary, we would not have the Eucharistic body of Christ. Without Mary, you would not have the mystical body of the church. Without Mary, Seriously, we would have nothing. How important is she? Tremendously important. Okay? And you know, I found something in my research that I thought was kind of important, so I'm going to mention it. It's secular science, so keep that in mind, secular science. And it's called chimerism. I keep trying to pronounce it wrong because it's the chi is a C-H-I instead of K-I. But it's, just in case you're looking it up, fetal chimerism. And it's about a woman's body. And they found out that women have living cells in their body that are not their own. Mothers. Not all women, but women who are mothers. The first thought was that they were making them sick because the concentration of cells near the areas of sickness in their body. They kept studying, and guess what they discovered? Oh no, it's not that it was making them sick, the exact opposite was happening. When a mother becomes sick, the cells of her children, all of her children, rush to that area of the body to help to heal her. I always wondered why my mother would never get sick and my dad would always get sick. Hey. This cellular exchange happens in the first trimester of pregnancy. It's amazing stuff. They found that women still in their old age still had cells of their children alive in their bodies, fighting for them. This is mind-blowing stuff. One of the scientists made a joke about it. He said that, we're always watching through mothers, and sometimes we think they have a sixth sense. And you know, my mom, I'd be coming home from school with a fake smile on my face, and she'd say, "What's wrong with you, Mom?" Or, "What's wrong with you, Bobby?" And he would say that it's not that mothers are watching over you or over your shoulder. No, no, she's in your shoulder. Why? Because it happens both ways, that all of you have living cells of your mothers in your body. And remember, Jesus is the God-man, human nature, full component of manhood that Our Lady gave him. What he needed and what he gave to her were the chromosomes of divinity. And the Heavenly Father supplied the rest in some way that we don't fully understand. But he was fully God and fully man, human nature. He has all of it. So there's a cellular exchange that took place between Mary and her son. So when the angels came to her and said, "Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee." Now he still remains in her body in a cellular level. Our Lady is the walking, living tabernacle and monstrance. Whenever she traveled with Joseph, it was like a Eucharistic procession. If those cells that God put in our mother's wombs and our mother's bodies will fight for our life and fight for her life, whose cells were in the body of Mary? Oh yeah, God's cells. Eh? Is Mary going to experience corruption in the tomb? Never. God loves his mother so much that implanting himself in his own souls in her body, her own cells in her body, that's why from the beginning of the church, we have never talked about the resurrection of Mary. On the 15th of August, we celebrate the Assumption of Mary. We have never celebrated a resurrection of Mary. Why? Because she never died. Not like you and I die. She experienced a passing, a transition, a dormation they call it, a falling asleep. God put himself inside her because he loves her so much. How special this woman is. What a masterpiece of God's motherhood and of femininity. When the shepherds came, they didn't walk by Mary to see the child and pick up the baby. No, no, they asked the mother if they could pick up the baby, right? Mary's baby, Mama's baby, born for you and for I, born into our hearts and born into our world. Let us, as we kind of look to the new year, let's find a way to put an extra prayer in our hearts for Mary every day so that we can grow. Because in those prayers, she will help us with struggles. And it will build up your strength as you turn to her. Because you'll be walking alongside of this incredible masterpiece of maternity that God created for you and for me and for his son. The great untier of knots will always be there for you if you ask her for help. Let us stand and profess our faith with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We now bring our petitions before the Lord. Through Jesus Christ and born of the Virgin Mary, let us welcome the year of our Lord, 2023, by turning to God in prayer.
For the church, that we may become a saving power in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and disadvantaged, that they may become like Christ in his triumph over injustice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, that all people will know God's peace and justice in their communities, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us all, that we trust in God's promises, even in the face of adversity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our sick relatives and friends, we pray for those names listed in our bulletin sick list. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our loved ones who have died, those who died this past week, those who rest in our cemeteries, and all those we remember in our garden of poinsettias, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own special needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Pope Benedict XVI, that the Lord will welcome him into his heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for peace, because today is the World Day of Peace, and we ask Our Lady to intercede, especially in Ukraine. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Lord God, by the help of Mary's prayers, keep us faithful in your service during this new year, and let our words and actions give glory to your name. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Baby boy was so bad.
pray, my sisters and brothers, that this, my sacrifice and yours, will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise and bless and glorify your name on the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesties, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, that we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy, with the entire people your Son has gained for his own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Especially today, we remember Pope Benedict XVI. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. May the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
Amen.
Offer each other a sign of that peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. such a special gift that we get to celebrate Our Lady, the Mother of God, on a Sunday. Generally, it's through the week, so it's nice to have this celebration on a Sunday. And it's great for us to recall how important she is in our lives. Certainly, if you want to look that up, it's really quite interesting that Mike Key Marison. You might want to look it up. It's an interesting thing about the fact that I still got some of my mom in me, even though she's gone. She's still there. So it's a wonderful thing about moms to have that wonderful gift. And certainly for the moms, it's a wonderful gift to know your sons are closer than you think. Your daughters are closer than you think. So we're very grateful for that. And it's a wonderful thing to contemplate our not only our Heavenly Mother, but our own mothers as we celebrate today. Just a reminder that the EDGE program will be on January 15th at 1 p.m. in the basement of the church. And the confirmation sponsor meeting is on Wednesday, January 11th at 7. And First Communion Parent Meeting is January 18th at 7. So Wednesday. So keep that in mind. I'd like to thank everyone who helped out with the food drive on behalf of Caledon Community Services. And of course, all who helped out with the joy drive. And the wonderful gift of giving that took place over Christmas. I thank the young people for bringing up the additions to our nativity scene. I always love those additions. It's always wonderful to have a little extra love around Jesus. So thank you so much, and continue to ask Our Lady to intercede. She's an incredible gift in our lives. And it's how we experience the love of Jesus. It's just like, I always love that image of the shepherds coming in, and the kings too. They would come in and they wouldn't, you know, push Mary aside and say, can I hold the baby? They'd just pick up the baby and they wouldn't do that. They'd say, Mary, can I hold the baby? Right? So if you ever need to hold Jesus, just ask Mary. She'll help you. Have a blessed, glorious, and wonderful week. I want to thank the musicians. We had a whole crew up there. So Kayla was up there. I think Maya was singing. So was Gabe. So was Tanisha. I think Tanisha's up there too. And of course, Sylvia, they did such a wonderful job with music. So I thank them for that. And all of you, the readers, Eucharistic ministers and ushers and altar servers, thank you so much for celebrating with us. And I think the little one is telling me I'm going too long. I should be quiet. So have a wonderful week. Let us stand and pray. We have received the heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And there's a special blessing. Sorry, I should have had that ready for the new year. May God, the source of origin of all blessings, grant you grace, pour out his blessing in abundance, and keep you safe from all harm throughout the coming year. Amen. May he give you integrity of faith and endurance and hope and perseverance in charity with holy patience until the end. Amen. May he order your days and your deeds in his peace, grant your prayers in this and every place, and lead you happily to eternal life. Amen. May the blessing of God, the Almighty Father, his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go forth in the peace and love of Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God.
And have a blessed day.